Welcome to the Scoop School Podcast, where we tackle your conundrums about the retail ice cream and frozen dessert business. And now, here's your host.
He still thinks that Napoleon Bonaparte's real name was Neapolitan Spoons Apart.
The ice cream bloke and self-appointed headmaster of Scoop School, Steve Christensen.
G'day ice cream lovers, my name's Steve Christensen. Hey, thanks for joining us. I do really appreciate it. We get a lot of comments, a lot of feedback. We get subscribers every single day to our YouTube channel and also those listening on the podcast. Podcast on iTunes, YouTube obviously shows the video. Subscribe and we'll jump a little bit of frozen dessert goodness in your inbox every single morning. We do want to thank our episode sponsor, which is Carpegiani. Carpegiani, manufacturers of batch freezers, soft serve machines, popsicle equipment, manufactured in Europe, in Italy, but distribution all around the world. Have a look and Google who your local representative is, carpegiani.com, C-A-R-P-I-G-A-I-N-A, carpegiani.com. Just say the word a couple of times in your sleep. Carpegiani, Carpegiani, it's beautiful. Rolls off the tongue just like silk. Now, I do want to talk a little bit about winterizing your equipment. We spoke in the last video about whether to open or whether to close and some of the factors that determine whether you open or close during the winter time, regardless of where you are in the world. If you do close or you're not using all of your equipment, it's important to winterize that equipment. And what I mean by that is having a service technician, either the manufacturer, preferably the manufacturer that's made your equipment, come in and do what we call a preventative maintenance or a PM visit to winterize your equipment. Now, just like you would winterize your irrigation system or some of your pipes at home, you do the same thing with your machine, or your technician should do the same thing with your machine. They generally will blow out those water lines if your machine is water cooled, make sure that there's not sitting or standing water in your machine that may freeze and crack pipes over the wintertime, and a number of other things that they can do to make sure that your machine, if you're shutting it down for the next 3, 4, 5 months sometimes, will be stored correctly and it won't damage over the winter period. It's really important to do that. I often suggest having a preventative maintenance check at the end of the season and having a preventative maintenance check at the beginning of the season, regardless of whether you're on the northern hemisphere or the southern hemisphere, because it really does keep your machine in tip-top condition. I hear too many stories of batch freezers, display cases, and other refrigeration equipment that has actually sat in a cold store over the winter period and actually was damaged by weather or by anything else, and it's a tragedy because it could have been prevented. So talk to your manufacturer about what preventative maintenance you can do as the operator and what preventative maintenance or winterizing that they can do as the authorized service provider. Sneeze coming. Excuse me. In any case, I'm not going to edit that out because it'll just show you how natural things are down here at Scoop School. If you have a question about the ice cream industry or you want anything to kind of look at, review, and study about the ice cream business, scoopschool.com is the place to go. Again, we thank our sponsor, Carpegiani. Their link is in the show notes. And if you have a conundrum that you would like us to deal with in the podcast here, drop us a line, steve@scoopschool.com. Keep on scooping, folks. We'll see you in the next video.